Rafa smiles. As you can imagine, the exchange at the net is very warm. So Djokovic gets the job done. Whether this fills him with much confidence going into the latter stages of the year, I'm not so sure. I almost feel as though it's a mini win for Rafa. Now, Djokovic points his finger towards Rafa there to say, look, this is the guy, the biggest rival of my career. And this is the guy we should be applauding and waving goodbye to. Rafa gives the crowd a wave. But as I say, some consolation I would suggest for Nadal is that I think this possibly should give him a bit more confidence going into the Davis Cup and also the potential of playing a singles match against Botic van der Zandschulp of the Netherlands in their first, in the quarterfinal that they will have. Show your appreciation for Rafa Nadal. I'm sure we'll get a few words, maybe from both players. Maybe we'll stay live to get those words. It's going to be a special tribute for Rafa. Of course, the head-to-head doesn't change from that exhibition match. 31-29, it remains and will remain as Rafa brings his career to a close. They can't, of course, play each other at the Davis Cup because Serbia didn't make the final eight. Little bit of a reprisal of the match. An early break from Novak at the beginning of the match meant he had an early advantage. He then sealed it with a second break of serve, meaning he won the first set 6-2. At that stage, the Rafa backhand in particular was looking vulnerable, particularly on the return. Occasional slices from Rafa when perhaps the Rafa of old would have hit double-handed backhands or even perhaps a few runaround forehands that he didn't take advantage of. And it was looking very comfortable for Novak when he took an early break advantage in the second set as he was leading one set and a break. But Rafa immediately broke back. Then we had Djokovic then, of course, on serve. But then Djokovic gets a crucial break at 4-all. Nadal did have some break points in the previous game, couldn't take advantage of those three break points, and it was actually Djokovic who then got the break and was then serving for the match, had a match point at 40-30, but some Rafa forehands of old came thundering down the court. Rafa broke back for 5-all. They go into the tie break, which was nip and tuck, but ultimately Djokovic did get over the line on his second match point, winning the match by 6-2, 7-6. Some good serving at times from Djokovic, but I would say his overall game was a little bit off today, but Rafa wasn't quite ready to punish it. Okay, so Djokovic is about to speak.
But also a recognition of where we are and what this event has meant to you. Congratulations on your play.
Thank you.
Assalamualaikum. Flexing his linguistic muscles.
The entire Sela team for organizing this incredible event. Congratulations, it was an amazing, amazing experience. Thank you for reminding us quite often now. It's been less than a year. I've been twice here in Riyadh playing tennis in front of the one of the most passionate crowds. Really amazing. Thank you all so much for coming every single match in big numbers and really showing your appreciation, respect, and support for this sport, for all the players. Thank you so much. It's been amazing. Now to Rafa. I don't know where to start. I'll go back to the very first match that we played against each other back in 2005, I think it was. And, you know, who would know that we are standing here almost 20 years later with more than 60 times that we face each other on the biggest stage in this sport. I have the utmost respect for you. Incredible athlete, incredible person. Incredible, really, it has been very intense. So I hope that we'll have a chance to maybe sit on the beach somewhere and have a little drink, reflecting on life, talking about something else, you know. And I would like to congratulate all your team and all your family on an amazing career that Rafa had. It's also your success. Sacrifice a family has to put into the career and the life of a professional tennis player. I can only imagine the highs and lows that you were going through with him. So you deserve his success as much as he does. So congratulations. Amazing, amazing career. I mean, it's difficult. I could speak all night, but I don't want to take away too much time. I think Rafa should speak instead of me. But once again, it's been an incredible honor, as I told you at the net. Incredible pleasure to share the court with you. You know, it's quite an emotional moment. You know, emotional day. You know, we've been playing so many matches. Over so many years, and don't leave tennis, man. Stay a little bit more. Stay with us. I will finish with one big thank you from not just me, but all of the tennis world for what you have done. You left incredible legacy, and Mark, and we really appreciate it.
So yeah, of course, the Davis Cup final is still to come for Rafa Nadal. Not quite the end of the road yet, but it's very, very soon. But I do think that today's performance result should give him a little bit of confidence going into the final eight in Malaga. And yes, tough decision for him. And of course, David Ferrer, the team captain, to make in terms of the singles. I think ultimately it'll be Rafa who decides, because I think David Ferrer is very keen for Rafa to play the singles match against the Netherlands and Botic van der Zandstroop. And perhaps this performance will encourage Rafa to do just that. We'll see. We'll have a few words from Rafa before we bring this show to a close. But in the meantime, do make sure you hit the like button and subscribe if you are new. We have a look back on some of Rafa's career here. It's his 22 Grand Slams. We're seeing some big moments.
Probably one of his last events.
14 French Open titles, of course. A further 8 Grand Slams across the other three events. Two Wimbledons, of course. 4 US Opens, 2 Australian Opens. Some kind words there from Yannick. 92 ATP Tour titles as well. Holger Rune there. Nadal there with the Wimbledon trophy. He has 2 of those in his trophy cabinet in Manacor. But let's maybe hear from Rafa himself, hopefully, very soon. Well, when Rafa speaks, we will get to hear from him. There'll be a few more Rafa shows on the channel in the coming weeks for sure. I've got one in particular planned, hopefully next week, which will be on the show, looking back on some big moments in Rafa's career. And we'll be covering him, of course, and his bow out from the sport in Malaga in a few weeks. A couple of weeks, well, a bit more, 3 or 4 weeks. He's being presented with a golden racket right now. Of course, 2 of the big 3 members, the other one, Roger Federer, retiring a couple of years ago. Are we now going to finally get to hear from Rafa himself? So let's listen to the man himself.
I'm sure not as well. A few words as you approach this stage in your career. It is not retirement, and we should state that, because you still have the small matter of the Davis Cup final still to go, but you've made the decision that you won't be playing tennis into next year and as a professional. What will you miss the most?
Well, I have to start being, thank you very much everyone here. Have been an amazing few days. Thank you to His Excellency and all the people who put together a great effort organizing this great event, bringing fantastic players and as Novak said, one of the most passionate crowds that we have played. So thank you very much for everything. I want to just say a few words to Novak and his team. Thank you very much for everything, for what you said today, and for all the moments that we shared on court during all our careers. Now, have been an amazing rivalry. I think, in a personal way, I have to say that you helped me to go over my limits during almost 15 years. So thank you for that, because without that, probably I will not be the player that I am today. Thank you. and congratulations for all the titles and amazing career to you, to your team, and wish all the very best of luck for the future. And answering your question, what I'm gonna miss the most is probably almost everything. No, having a dream come true, be able to play for almost 20 years of career, being competitive, and having the chance to play in the best places in the world, best tournaments, best stadiums, something that I watched on TV when I was a kid. So at the end, I realized my dream to become a professional tennis player and be a successful one. And I really can't thank enough the support and the love that I received all around. Having an amazing energy in every single tournament that I was able to play during all these years. Huge support, of course, from my team, from my family, but at the same time, from all the tennis world. It has been a huge pleasure to be around. I feel very fortunate, guy, to be a tennis player. We have a great tour and a lot of great people running the sport. So I feel very fortunate, and I want to thank you, everyone.
So, Rafa, more time at the academy, more time with business interests around the world. It's a very, very exciting time. What comes next for you? More time with well, he's not a baby anymore, with baby Rafa. He thought you were great tonight, by the way. We all did. He thought you were fantastic. But he thought the little spider he was watching was even better. So from all of us who have watched you in all these years, I'm sure you know what you've given us. You've thrilled us. You've been the one out here sacrificing your body and your mind and enjoying yourself, I hope, as well. But it has been a singular pleasure for all of us to watch your career. And most importantly, if I may say so, the way you've handled yourself, be we just in the media or the public or your opponents. Thank you very much. Rafa Nadal, ladies and gentlemen.
There we go. So, chance of Rafa from the crowd. Okay, so that brings today's show to an end. Thank you very much for joining, and I'm sure we'll catch up again very soon. And yeah, thanks for tuning in.
If you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit that like button. Don't forget to subscribe and click that notification bell so you don't miss out on all things tennis.